And here is the Writer's Almanac for Sunday, January the 3rd, 2021. It's the birthday of Lucretia Mott, born Nantucket, Massachusetts, 1793. She was a teacher in a Quaker boarding school near Poughkeepsie, New York, and quit when she found out that she was being paid less than half of what the male teachers all made simply because she was a woman. She got into the women's rights movement, and along with Elizabeth Cady Stanton, she organized a convention for women's rights, the Seneca Falls Convention of 1848. Lucretia Mott, who wrote, "The world has never yet seen a truly great and virtuous nation, because in the degradation of women, the very fountains of life are poisoned at their source." It was on this day, 1841, Herman Melville, 21 years old, set sail aboard the whaling vessel Acushnet from the port of New Bedford, Massachusetts, bound for the Pacific. He didn't have much experience as a seaman, but he loved the sea. He was eager to learn. Whaling was still big business, 1841. Whale oil from whale blubber, the most widely available fuel for lights, also one of the most popular lubricants. He learned the ins and outs of whaling. He helped to harpoon the whales, harvest them, process their oil, also listened to the stories that his fellow seamen told, particularly of a legendary white sperm whale called Moby Dick. And all of it gave Herman Melville material that he was to use in writing his book Moby Dick. It's the birthday of the writer who created Bilbo, Gandalf, Gollum, Frodo, introduced readers to a place called Middle Earth and a magical ring. J.R.R. Tolkien, born 1892 in South Africa, creator of the Lord of the Rings trilogy, came out in 1955. Family moved to England when he was just 4 years old. He loved the English countryside. He was reading by the age of four, starting to learn Latin, developed a love for Arthurian legends. Went off to World War I, fought with the Lancashire Fusiliers, was wounded in action, became a professor of languages and literature at Oxford, where he took 17 years to write his three books. He wrote them with two fingers on a typewriter, Lord of the Rings. Tolkien, who said readers read too much into his books, he said, "I don't like allegories. I never liked Hans Christian Andersen because I knew he was always getting at me." He said about his hobbits, "There is little or no magic about them except the ordinary everyday sort, which helps them to disappear quietly and quickly when large stupid folk like you and me come blundering along, making a noise like elephants, which they can hear a mile off. They are inclined to be fat in the stomach. They dress in bright colors, chiefly green and yellow, wear no shoes because their feet grow natural leathery soles and thick warm brown hair like the stuff on their heads, which is curly. They have long, clever brown fingers, good-natured faces, and laugh deep, fruity laughs, especially after dinner, which they have twice a day when they can get it." Here's a poem for today by David Budbill. Winter is the best time. Winter is the best time to find out who you are. Quiet contemplation time, away from the rushing world. Cold time, dark time, holed up, pulled in time and space to see that inner landscape, that place hidden and within. David Budbill's poem, Winter is the Best Time, from While We've Still Got Feet, published by Copper Canyon Press and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac, funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.